Hello, my name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. In Sapphire 2022.5, Sapphire for Photoshop has the ability to work with alpha channels. And if you're working with effects that use or generate up their own alpha channel, you may see a slight color shift when you're using them. I'm going to tell you why it's happening and how you can fix it with two clicks. Okay, so here we have a text and a logo, both of which have an alpha channel. So if I come into my Sapphire and start with a new layout, you'll see the checkerboard, meaning that we do have alpha coming straight through. I'm going to turn my checkerboard off for a second up in view so we can see this here. And I'm going to add just one effect, which is ultra glow. And I'll come in and load up a preset and we'll take discotheque. So let's take a little look at that. What I will do actually is come into my edges and just change that up a little bit. There we go. So we can see we've got a nice big glow. And if I turn on my checkerboard, we're still getting the alpha channel out. Excellent. So if I hit OK now and take us back into Photoshop, this looks pretty good, but it doesn't look exactly the same as it did in Builder. And the reason for this is the way that Photoshop deals with effects with alpha channels as they're coming back in. And here's how we get the exact same colors between the two. I'm going to Control or Command click on my thumbnail here to create a selection from my alpha channel. Then I'm going to come down to the bottom and I'm going to add a layer mask. And if I just alt click on this, you can see that's the alpha channel that we're needing to take out. So what we've done is we've added in a layer mask that Photoshop was missing. So now we've got that exact same look as we had in Builder. And you can see this even more clearly if we're dealing with something that generates up an alpha channel, like a lens flare. So if I come in and I'll create a solid black color, come back into Sapphire, and let's convert this one to a smart object. Start off with something new and let's type in lens flare, add that one in. I will load up a preset. It doesn't really matter what one we choose. I just want to show you something that has a lot of color in it so we can actually see the issue. So this nice big blue one here, I'm going to do one last thing under combine at the bottom. Let's change that to flare only. So it's going to be taking out an alpha channel as well. So let's hit OK on that. And again, we have that same issue where the colors are coming through and they're not quite the same as they need to be. So the solution is the same. Control or Command click on the layer thumbnail to generate up a selection and then add a layer mask. And now we have our flare compositing correctly with all the colors correct as well. And that's all there is to it. If you're taking out an effect with an alpha channel from the Sapphire, you need to remember to add a layer mask to that layer in Photoshop. I hope that's been helpful for you. My name is Ben Brownlee and I'll see you again in another Sapphire tutorial soon. Thanks for watching. To learn more about Sapphire for Photoshop or any of the Boris Effects products, head on over to borisfx.com, where you can find hours of free training and free trial versions of all of the software. And if you want to be one of the first to watch the new tutorials, remember to hit that subscribe button.